What up, everybody? I'm Thomas III, co-host of Dem Dem Indians on Talk Jive Radio. Welcome to the Weed U, and thank you for joining us again for our next presentation, our next, show you how to do some stuff here. We're about to get our MacGyver on today, so I'm going to show y'all how to make what's called a gravity bong. Now, the concept can be applied a lot of different ways, but for this demonstration right here, we're going to use a 3-liter bottle, a 2-liter bottle. Now, these are soda bottles. Doesn't matter what kind. You just need one that's bigger around than the other one. So we have our two bottles of soda that are emptied out and washed out and all that. Now, we only need one of the lids from it, and you'll see why later. We have some stuff that you would just commonly find around, like laying in your junk drawer maybe, or in the shed or whatever. So this is just a common socket. It's a 9/16, something that just might be laying around. Some tape that we found, I don't know, sparkly, whatever. We have our box cutter. We're gonna need this to cut these up and to make a hole in this. And we're about to rig it up, so let's do it. Okay, now the first step to building any bong is to put your bowl together. So, we did a video before about using foil if you're in a dire need. Always prefer something that's a little more sturdy, because your foil is gonna kind of fall apart. And the best case scenario is to find a bowl that was to a pipe or a bong that maybe got broken or whatever, and you just kind of kept the parts. And so that's always good like that. But like I said, if you don't have anything else, nice little socket will work. Now, you see how the socket, it's got that little depth to it, but it's got shoulders inside of there. You know what I mean? And that's gonna it's gonna make it easier to put something down in there. Now, if we had a screen, or if I was gonna go, take one out of a faucet or something, then we could just stuff that down in there, with a pin or whatever, and get that screen right. But what we're gonna have to do for this one is, that's what we got this little piece of foil. So that's what we're gonna use for the screen. Now, the first thing we're gonna have to do, we're gonna have to draw this out. We're gonna have to cut it as good as we can. Now, we don't have perfect tools for this. If it was a perfect world, you would have drills and all this different kind of stuff to make perfect cuts and, stuff to seal it off. But this is like, if you were sitting at home and you were just trying to make something to smoke out of. So, all right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna trace this, and we're gonna attempt to make a cut as perfect as possible around it, that this bowl is gonna be able to kind of sit down in. Things moving around quite a bit. All right, so that's an ugly circle there, but we got a basic circle here. Do something like this. You gotta be careful, these things will cut you. But, and like I said, it's not gonna be perfect. It's gonna be pretty ugly, but the good thing about plastic like this is that it kind of moves. You can kind of fit it on in there and try to just seal it up. And that's what we got the tape for, because you need something to seal off that you don't get too much air in there. So I'll probably have to cut a little bit more out, because you always want to make your first cuts inside the circle that you have there, because you can always cut more out, but you know, there's only so much you can't add more to it. So if you can get it in there, let's see, I may be able to kind of catch that little lip that's on the right there. Okay, so we have our bowl inside the little lid, and you can see on the inside like that. But you're still probably going to want to put some tape around it, just to make sure that it stays airtight. And we may not even need this much foil, but we'll go ahead and see. Mm. I'm gonna push that foil down in there like so. And we're gonna take our little pin and poke some holes in there. Get a couple little holes down there in the bottom. That should be enough to let the smoke get through. And like I said, you know, best case scenario, you would want to do this with the actual screen, but you know, a lot of times you don't have what you would normally want, you know, so just got to work with whatever you can and make it work. So there's our bowl. That's what we're going to use on the top of it. All right. Now, for a gravity bong, basically what you need is you need one bottle that's bigger around than another bottle. So we have a 3 liter and a 2 liter. Now, if you wanted to make a smaller one, you could do a 2 liter and a 1 liter, or you could do, there's a lot of different ways to do it, but just for our sake, for what we're doing here, we're gonna take our big one and our little one, whichever one that you wanna do. Now the big one, what you wanna do is you wanna cut it at the top. So you wanna cut the top off, basically. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna get started, try to make it as straight as possible. I know it's kind of hard when you're cutting plastic. Get that basically pretty even. It, you know, we're not doing this to make it pretty, we're just doing this to you know, for the purposes of what we're doing. Now the smaller one, that's our big one, so we're going to use that one. Now, smaller one, you're going to want to do the exact opposite. You're going to want to cut this one on the bottom, okay? And if you have a little seam like that to reference, a lot of times that's better. But I mean, if you're a perfectionist and you're all OCD and all that, then you'll probably want to actually draw it out and cut it just right. I know a lot of people that are like that, that just would never be able to allow themselves to cut something at an angle. Okay, so this is what we have. We have our two pieces here. We have this piece that's gonna sit inside of here, and then we have this piece that's gonna go right up on top of here. Now, what you do with this is you are going to fill this up with water. You can pretty much fill it all the way up to wherever, as long as it's still holding water. But you're gonna fill this up with water, you're gonna set this in here, and we're gonna tape off this bowl. And then what we're gonna do is put this bowl on top of here, load it up with flour, and then you're gonna lift this as you light it. So the gravity of the water is actually what's pulling on the bowl. And so you don't have to actually do any of the work of like filling the chamber. You don't have to have a carb, none of that stuff. It's all right here. So what you do is, once that gets full and you have your water line down here, you take this off right here, and then you just push it back down and all that smoke comes out. All right, so we got everything here. We got a little flour. This is some, some white gummy bear. It's nice, it's pretty nice. So we're gonna load this bowl up here. And you know, the good thing about this isn't a really huge bowl, so you're not gonna burn a whole lot of flour up, you know? And it's all a personal thing, however much you wanna, However big of a bowl you think you need. This is actually something more of like a party thing. You're not gonna be doing this on the regular, just trying to, you know, cause this will, and you know, we gotta tell our list, or you know, our watchers out there, that do this stuff at your own risk, because this thing could hit pretty hard. So you know, this is all do at your own risk type of stuff right here. Okay, so we have the water there. Now you see the gravity is gonna suck on that, just sucking air in right there. So let's move this out of the way. So let's get it lit here. See that? And I'm not even gonna do close to a hole. Whew. That's a good one. Whew. And you can fill it all the way up if you want to. That's what I did one time. Yeah. All right, everybody. Now that was our tutorial on how to make a gravity bomb. Now, like I said, you can change this up however you want. If you want a bigger bowl than this, you can use a bigger bowl. You can buy a bowl for it. I'm sure you can make one that looks a lot prettier than this. But you know, like I said, it's just all about function. Now, I have seen at some parties before a really bad idea. Somebody made one out of a Culligan jug and had it sitting in the tub. I wouldn't recommend that. Unless you got quite a few people that are willing to take on that responsibility of clearing that chamber, because if not, you're going to waste some weed. But, you know, thank you for joining us right here on The Weed U. Of course, as always, like, subscribe, click the little bell button so that you get the notifications, man. And we're going to be dropping a new one of these every Friday at 4:20 from here on out. Now, don't forget to go check out the merch room on talkjob.org. We have some new ashtrays. Our pocket ashtrays are here. We have white with purple writing and green with white writing for the Weed U. We got a lot more merchandise coming, so keep on checking out that merch room. There's gonna be new stuff all the time. And of course, for everybody here at the Weed U, I tell you, no better buds. And for everybody here at Talk Job and the Weed U, I'm Thomas III, saying peace. That's a good one. Whew.